everyone. Once again, I'm Janice Way, the president of Leadership Kentucky, and thank you for being seated. Welcome to the 22nd annual Alumni Luncheon and Flame of Excellence presentation. Plus, this year, we're celebrating the 40th anniversary of Leadership Kentucky. We are thrilled and thankful to have with us today so many of you who have made this program the great program that it is over the last 40 years, and those of you who will ensure that this program grows and thrives for the next 40, 120, whatever years, right? We're just getting started. We're just getting this party started, right, DJ? So, speaking of our 40th anniversary, I want to point out a couple of things at your table. Two special items that we want you to take home and enjoy. First is a little program commemoration, a lot about the history of Leadership Kentucky, which you'll hear a little bit more about today. But it's always nice to know what got you here, right? And so we've put that together for you. Also, just a little fun thing, a little glass coaster with the 40th anniversary logo on it. Thank you to Run Switch PR for developing that for us. But just a little thing for you to enjoy at your home or office, so don't forget those today as you leave. And I've mentioned him a couple of times, but let's hear it for DJ Miracle. He's been playing the hits from the last 40 years. And we'll hear a little bit more from him later on. I would obviously like to start out by acknowledging our alumni luncheon sponsors. You'll see them on the front of the program, at your table, and big signs along the way and on the screens behind. But they make this luncheon possible for you to come and enjoy. LG&E KU, CHI St. Joseph Health, Norton Healthcare, Planters Bank, Republic Bank, Run Switch PR, U.S. Bank, Whitaker Foundation, Wyatt, the Flame of Excellence sponsor, Sutherland & Associates, and to the Central Bank Center for their support and assistance with this beautiful venue. If you are representing one of those companies, please stand so that we can recognize you and say thank you. Our sponsoring companies, please stand. Now I would like to ask Carlos Sanchez. Carlos, where are you? Okay, come on up. Woo! Carlos was the 2023 Lisa Mural Award winner, and he is going to share a couple of words of inspiration before we start our meal today. And while he's making his way up to the stage, just a reminder for those of you who are in earlier classes, the Lisa Mural Award is voted on by the class to the person that they think of their fellow class members most demonstrate the attributes of loyalty, humility, caring, and grace. It was named for Lisa Mural, who was a member of the 2008 class. She developed cancer, but her class said, "You're not leaving us. You are not dropping out this year. We are going to make sure that you enjoy every minute with us." And sometimes they even carried her places. So that's the kind of person she was. And they voted on this award for the last several years. And that's the kind of person that Carlos is. Carlos Sanchez, the 23 Lisa Mural Award winner.
Thank you, Janice. Appreciate those words, and it's great to see so many familiar faces. And a shout out to my Leadership Kentucky class of 2023. Where is 2023? There it is. Just keep in mind, it's the Commonwealth class. I'm very honored to bring these brief remarks about my experience with Leadership Kentucky. Certainly, Leadership Kentucky has meant so much for our Commonwealth for the past 40 years. What would the next 40 years look like? the sky's the limit as far as I'm concerned. This organization is so vital for the formation and development of our current and future leaders and for the well-being of our state. So many people ask me, why apply to Leadership Kentucky? Why do this program? And I said to them, because it showed me areas and topics that I would have not seen otherwise. Because I learned about the history of the Commonwealth, and only understanding the history, you can really create a path to shape the future. Because it gave me a network of friends and colleagues that I can call on to work on initiatives and build a better Kentucky. Because it gave me unique moments that I'll remember for the rest of my life. Like the moment when a young student from the GEO International School in Bowling Green told his story to our class. It so happened that this boy is from Colombia, where I'm from the same city that I'm from. It was a story very similar to mine. So I said to this child, whose name is Santiago, I was you when I came to this country, the same age and similar conditions. I know what you're going through and how you feel when other kids tell you you don't speak English well or you have an accent like mine. I said, you don't pay attention to that. You stay focused on your school, study hard, and be the best that you can be. Because this country offers amazing opportunities. And the sky's the limit as to where you can go. Kentucky has a place for you in your future. I think I inspired him. I'm now mentoring Santiago. Those are the moments that build a community, the moments that can make a state better. This is why I say Leadership Kentucky is the best experience I've had in my short tenure here in Kentucky, about a year and a half going on 2 years in April. Certainly, this experience did improve my state, my well-being, and I believe our class improved our state, our beloved Kentucky. Thank you.
So just a couple of additional things about Carlos. You can see why he's just so amazing and was voted on by the class. But he was also in our new executives program and had such a good time. He said, I want to be in your program next year. So there he was. But a funny thing about Carlos, there wasn't a session that he didn't go up to somebody and make a connection with one of the speakers. And when we were sitting there in Bowling Green listening to that young man talk about his story, I looked at one of the class members sitting next to me. I said, $10, Carlos will be up there before the end of this panel discussion and talking to that young man, and indeed he was. Carlos managed to make a connection with everybody this year. Carlos Sanchez. And speaking of our devotion to our state, what a perfect way to launch our luncheon, but to hear from the 2019 class alum, Michelle Bundren, as she leads us in My Old Kentucky Home. Michelle.
Will y'all please stand? The sun shines bright in the old Kentucky home. 'Tis summer, the people are gay. The corn tops are ripe and the meadows in the bloom as the birds make music all the day. The young folk roll on the little cabin floor, all happy, all merry and bright. By and by, They come a knocking at the door, then my old Kentucky home good night. And everybody sing with me. And weep no more, my lady. Oh, weep no more today. And we will sing one song for my old Kentucky home, for my old Kentucky home far away. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Michelle. The hidden talents you find out people during Kentucky programs. So let's continue with our lunch, visit with your friends, and we'll convene back here in just a few minutes to get started with our program, but enjoy your lunch and your friends. We certainly hope you are enjoying your meal and visiting with friends, but we need to get started in order to keep us on time today. So feel free to finish up your food, enjoy your dessert while we get started. I'd like to recognize those of you who have served as our board of directors any time over the last 40 years. If you are a current or former member of the Board of Leadership Kentucky, please stand. Current or former or brand new to the board this year. Thank you so much. We are especially fortunate today to have with us several past board chairs over the years. You're going to hear from Perry Allen in just a moment from 2023. Dan Borg from 2021. As I say your name, please stand. Mary Michael Corbett, 2017. By the way, Mary Michael was in the very first class of 1985. She is not. She says she's ancient. She is not. She was 20 when she went through the class, right? But anyway, we're just so thrilled to have you here because she has stayed really involved since 1985 and just rotated off the board this year. Thank you. Barbara Dickens from 2020. Teresa Hale, 2019. Billy Harper, 2004. Regina Jackson, 2022. Jim Miller, 2011. Mike Owsley, 2007. John Richards, 1989 and 1990. He loved it so much he had to stay 2 years. And he still is involved, as you will hear more about later. Lytle Thomas, 2016, and Elmer Whitaker, 2018. Thank you to all of these past board chairs. You know, as past board chairs, no one knows more than you all how every year, every class thinks they are the best class ever. And we'll be taking pictures with this later on too, by the way. But, you know, some years, classes prove it by their attendance at this luncheon. There's a couple of classes we want to really highlight. Of course, the most recent 2023 class of Leadership Kentucky, four tables of you back there. Yeah. Make some noise. We know you can. And the 2022 class also has four tables. There you go. 2023, are you really going to let them be louder than you? Come on. So we're overwhelmed by how many alums we have here today, about 275 of you to celebrate with us. And I would also like to acknowledge that there are quite a few of you from any class of the 1980s, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89. If you were in one of the classes in the 80s, in the very early years, please stand. I just have to say a special shout out to the 1987 class. That was mine and my buddy Mike and Bill from the 87 class. Oh, and Donna. Donna's here. I hope I didn't leave out anybody, but there we go. We also have an unbelievable showing from two of our newest programs. That's Bright and Elevate. We have several, I think, maybe five or six tables of them here. So all the Bright and Elevate folks, stand up and be recognized, please. Two wonderful new programs under the direction of Karen Butcher. Throughout the year, yay, okay. Throughout the year, our corporate and session sponsors make our signature Leadership Kentucky program, Elevate, Bright, and new executives affordable and possible for about 150 people a year. Please join me in a huge round of applause for all of our sponsors, which hopefully you have seen scrolling on the screen and will continue to scroll through on the screen. We try to promote them as much as possible. We just can't say thank you enough. So a huge round of applause. As I said, we try to promote these sponsors throughout the year on our website, at the sessions, on social media. And speaking of that, we try to promote all the things that we are doing for our graduates and for the current class. So we urge you to follow us on social media. If you don't, Lisa has all of the information. There she is, Lisa Spire, our communications coordinator and office manager. She has all of the information posted on social media and our emails that we send out monthly or more often in the newsletter. If we don't have your current email address, please get it to Lisa so that we can get everything updated and the information to you. But some of the special things that I just want to mention briefly that we have planned for the 40th anniversary year is a trip to Alaska in June. And soon to be coming in next week's newsletter, Australia in January. So every year we ask the new class, if you could go anywhere in the world, where would you want to go? And every year we hear people say, Australia and New Zealand. So we're going to make it happen. So sign up. We have also a wonderful alumni golf outing planned for September, thanks to a group from the 2023 class. Jeremy and a bunch of his friends from the 23 class are planning a golf outing. You'll be hearing more about that. And several regional chapter receptions. Also, some interesting videos that we'll be posting this year. So lots to look forward to in our 40th anniversary year. As most of you know, Leadership Kentucky and the Board of Directors accepts nominations for the Flame of Excellence Award each year. The nominees are among the who's who, and you'll be hearing from some of them later, but it's the who's who of Kentucky, the people who have really touched the heart of Kentucky. The winner is celebrated every year at this luncheon. And as the board discussed who we should honor this year, it was decided there are so many important people who created Leadership Kentucky and has propelled it to the place it is today. We thought, why not honor so many of them, all of them? So this year, we're doing something a little different. We're honoring our founders of Leadership Kentucky. And for that, I would like to introduce our very first Leadership Kentucky president, who was there at the beginning and worked with all these folks and made it all happen, one of my very favorite people, Julie Schmidt, the first president of Leadership Kentucky. Well, good afternoon. I scripted myself, so I'll stay on track. There's so much to talk about at the beginning years, and I can't even begin to tell you how exciting it is for all of us in those early days to see each and every one of you all here and know what you're doing in your own communities. There's a brief history in your program that outlines the formation and launch of Leadership Kentucky. I feel that it's important to remember and appreciate the people that got us to where we are today. I'd like to mention just a few of the highlights that are listed. In the early 80s, local leadership programs were beginning to be established all across this great state in Lexington, Owensboro, Danville, Murray, Ashland, Northern Kentucky, and Louisville. And to our knowledge, there are only two other statewide programs in America. Young, civic-minded leaders, Dave Atkinson of Owensboro and Bob Babbage of Lexington, along with Laura, his wife, and another amazing leader, had witnessed success in their own community programs, and they conceived the idea of a state leadership experience, what it could mean for Kentucky's future. There was great promise in the concept, bringing together emerging leaders from across the Commonwealth to delve into the complex issues facing our great state while visiting the various regions and experiencing our unique and special culture. They, along with Laura, reached out to Joan Ream, who was instrumental in the founding of Leadership Louisville, and asked her to join with them. Together, they all recognized they needed a prominent Kentuckian to serve as the inaugural chairman. And that person was Wilson W. Wyatt, Sr. of Louisville. He was gracious and provided sound counsel on what was needed to move forward. Joan Ream contacted fellow Louisvillian John Richards, who was at the time serving as the chair of the Kentucky Chamber of Commerce. And John embraced the idea and has been a complete champion for Leadership Kentucky from that day forward. They also met with the executive director. He was newly hired, Jim Wiseman of the Kentucky Chamber, who also gave his full support. And it was an exciting time. Every person that Mr. Wyatt extended an invitation to join on the board of directors replied affirmatively, enthusiastically, and backed the program without hesitation. The inaugural members are listed in your program, and we're so grateful because of them, this program had a successful launch and continues to be because of the leaders that have followed their footsteps. We're pleased to have with us today two of those members. Governor Paul Patton of Pikeville was on the inaugural board, along with Bob Babbage of Lexington. And Billy Harper of Paducah was on the Kentucky State Chamber of Commerce board when they endorsed the support for Leadership Kentucky. In those early years, wherever the program sessions were held, the community came out in support, the business leaders, the community leaders, and as Laura and I were just talking about, we had to raise the money for everything, and we were so overwhelmingly supported. Everyone was so gracious, and it truly exceeded our expectations. Now, it's my honor to recognize the Leadership Kentucky founders. Unfortunately, Jim Wiseman couldn't be here today, and also Dave Atkinson couldn't come, but we'll be sure to follow up and make sure that they receive their awards. We're so pleased to have Laura Babbage, Bob Babbage, and our champion, who's flown in from Florida, John Richards, to be with us and celebrate this important anniversary milestone. We're grateful to each and every one of you all, and if you'd please come forward. just a little addition here, off the script. Another founder, Julie Schmidt. What really inspires all of us today is how Leadership Kentucky continues to evolve. And when you all stood up a moment ago, you can't imagine the spirit that you gave all of us, the inspiration to have the new young leaders and how you've expanded to new leaders in Kentucky. There's just so much going on with this program, and we are so grateful to Janice, to the staff, to the board and the alumni that continues to support this program and take it to even greater heights. So we just want to say thank you to you. Now, this is a little awkward, but I'm going to segue into the Flame of Excellence Award. And I can't begin to tell you what a complete honor this is for me as Wilson W. Wyatt Sr. was such an incredible statesman for Kentucky, and we're honored to donate or to give this award posthumously in his honor. He truly embodied the spirit of the award. With his analytical mind, his life experiences, and winning personality, he looked for ways to bring people together, and through the diplomatic way, find solutions. He indeed left an indelible mark in, I should have put these on at the beginning. He indeed left an indelible mark in Louisville and our great Commonwealth of Kentucky. Wilson Watkins Wyatt was born in 1905 and grew up in Louisville, and in his words, with modest means. Mr. Wyatt credited his parents, Father Richard, for his disciplined lifestyle, and his mother Mary, for instilling a love of reading and a desire to learn. Wilson was particularly fond of autobiographies, and at the age of 9, after reading about Benjamin Franklin and others, he dreamed of becoming an attorney and active in public service. And so he did, graduating as valedictorian of Louisville Male High School, class of 1923. He worked for the L&N Railroad during the day while attending the former Louisville Jefferson School of Law in the evenings. He worked diligently, establishing a reputation as a fine lawyer, while also being active in civic affairs and politics. He was extremely popular. In 1941, at the age of 35, Mr. Wyatt was elected as the youngest mayor of Louisville, Kentucky. Just days following being sworn into office, the country was attacked at Pearl Harbor and went to war. As mayor, he propounded sound leadership and remained focused on war-related concerns throughout his term. In 1959, Mr. Wyatt returned to public office, elected as lieutenant governor, serving with Bert T. Combs as governor. He had a significant role in the administration and led the newly established Kentucky Economic Development Council. Governor Wyatt had a long and distinguished career and continued his lifelong commitment to public service. Among his many roles, he chaired the University of Louisville and Bellarmine University's Board of Trustees and countless other organizations, just to name a few. He and his wife, Ann, his complete partner, were generous philanthropists and invested significantly in education to U of L, Bellarmine, and the Jefferson County Public Schools. And in his so-called retirement years, he enjoyed spending a little time on his farm in Shelby County, whistle stops, all the while helping establish Leadership Louisville with his dear long-term friend, Barry Bingham Sr. And in 1984, serving as the founding chair and guiding light of Leadership Kentucky, of which he remained committed to this organization's success long after. I, along with the others, acknowledged a few minutes ago the founders and those highlighted in your program, and there were many, were privileged to work alongside Mr. Wyatt
as we developed Leadership Kentucky in the mid-1980s. He would have been so proud to see how this program has grown and influenced thousands throughout the Commonwealth. In closing, I'd like to share Chairman Wilson Wyatt's charge that he gave to us many years ago, and I quote, "Back in the days of ancient Greece, every man on achieving manhood was required to take an oath, the effect of which to leave his community better than he found it. And I invite all of you, and I know that you will, to take the pledge to leave our community and state better than we found it. Or as the Leadership Kentucky motto today says, improve your state. I am humbled to honor Wilson W. Wyatt Sr., the spark that lit the flame of Leadership Kentucky, and to accept this special award on behalf of Mr. Wyatt and his firm is Leadership Kentucky graduate and Wyatt partner, Tyson Gorman."
Julie, thank you for those kind words. As Julie said, I'm Tyson Gorman. I'm a partner at Wyatt Tarrant Combs, and I'm here, could not be more proud to accept this award on behalf of our namesake. It's frankly fairly amazing that almost 30 years after his passing, that he still is remembered as fondly. His words still ring as true. And this organization is kind enough to award him this honor. So we do appreciate that. I'll close by relaying a quote that was relayed at the time of Mr. Wyatt's passing. He died at the age of 90 back in 1996. Another elder Kentucky statesman at that point, Ned Breathitt, former Governor Ned Breathitt, had this to say. He said that Kentucky had lost its number one statesman in losing Wilson Wyatt. Those words were true then. It appears they're true today. And it is my great honor to accept this award on behalf of Mr. Wyatt, his family, and the great law firm that I've been privileged enough to be a part of that he started so long ago. Thank you all very much. Appreciate it.
This portrait of Mr. Wyatt is in the Leadership Kentucky office in Frankfort. And as I said earlier, it's always important to remember the people that got you where you are today. And certainly Mr. Wyatt, the founders and others got us to where we are today. And we're very, very grateful, and it's our honor to acknowledge them today. So, As Julie said, thank you very much. That was wonderful, by the way. The formation of Leadership Kentucky has really meant so much to, over now, 2,500 graduates of our programs, one of our four programs over the years. And it really is remarkable to see what our graduates are out there doing and what they have been doing over the last 40 years. And Julie failed to say this because she's so humble, but she came up with the Flame of Excellence Award idea. So just another one of the great things. And in her two stints as president of Leadership Kentucky, the very first and then again in the 2000s, thank you for all you've done. So speaking of other Flame of Excellence winners, we are thrilled to have some past Flame of Excellence winners with us today. So as I say your name, would you please stand and let us recognize you. Lee Todd, 2013. Bill Goodman, 2014. John Williams, 2015. Helen Carroll, 2016. And I just have to add this about Helen. So when the program coordinator position for Leadership Kentucky opened, I called Helen and I said, hey, we've got this opening. She had just retired from Toyota. I thought she might know somebody that, you know, would be interested in the position. I said, do you know anybody that might like this job? And she goes, what am I, chop liver? And I said, are you serious? You would be interested? She said, I love Leadership Kentucky. Class member, former board member, Flame of Excellence winner, and now coordinator for Leadership Kentucky. Thank you, Helen. Bill Jones, 2017. Getting a refill on his coffee over there, Bill Jones. PG Peoples, 2021. And Paul Patton, 2022. We honored the former governor and his wife, Judy, last year, and it's so nice to have you back. And please tell Judy we said hello. So, one other thing to pass along before I pass the torch to the chair. We're so excited that you are here today. We urge you to stay around as long as you want. Well, maybe not as long as you want, but for a while afterwards. We have the room until about 2 o'clock. So if you would like to mix and mingle for a little bit at the conclusion of the program, that's wonderful. We have a few of you I know that are interested in recording some additional videos that we're doing in the back of the room, some testimonials that Runswitch PR is doing for us today, and we'll be promoting on our website throughout the year. So feel free to go back there and also do that. It just takes a couple of minutes. And Jennifer is our... There you are. Jennifer, thank you so much from Jennifer Phelps from our staff out there with registration, coordinating everything. She's also going to have some folks out there, and thank you to all the registration people who helped us today, collecting name tags. If you don't want to carry your name tag home with you, just drop them in the baskets out there. She'll have those for you. So, all right, just get that little business out of the way. So, as Wilson Wyatt, you've heard, was our very first chair of the Leadership Kentucky Board of Directors, it's time now, 40 years later, to install the 2024 chair of Leadership Kentucky. But first, we want to say thank you to our 23 chair and hear a little bit from Perry Allen. Perry.
Thanks, Janice. Appreciate it a bunch. What a pleasure you've been to work with over the years while I served on the board and most recently as chair. Before I go much further, though, I want to say this correctly, my former boss, Bill Jones, for getting me into Leadership Kentucky. Bill nominated me at one point in 2014 for the 2014 class, and Leadership Kentucky has meant so much to me over the years. Prior to becoming a member in the class, something I wanted to do, and Bill gave me the opportunity to step out and to do that. So thanks, Bill. Appreciate it a bunch. Also, I heard a little applause at the 2014 class. At that point, they voted on who got to become a member of the board for Leadership Kentucky. And I think that was the only year when I got elected, they said, we don't want to do this anymore. but I do thank the classmates that are here and appreciate that a bunch. So many great leaders have been recognized here today, and I know one item that each would speak to, which is the same for each of you and the same for me. Leadership Kentucky played a vital role in helping each to become the leader that they are. and it did so much for me. When I came into Leadership Kentucky and then onto the board, you know, it's kind of like, you know, high school to college and beyond. You think you know a whole lot till you get to the next level, and then you've got a whole new opportunity to learn more. And that's what I did. From the classmates of 2014 and the classmates before then that I've been fortunate to be able to get to know over time, and it's been a pleasure for me to participate and play a role, but helping each to become the leader that we all have became. I want to thank Janice and the Leadership Kentucky team. Anybody that has worked with Janice and the team in this capacity or just as a member of a class, it's always a pleasure and makes your responsibility, my responsibility, very easy. I want to thank the Leadership Board, Kentucky Leadership Board, and each of you for helping to sponsor Leadership Kentucky in some fashion, either through being a member, through your alumni dues, through donating, through being a sponsor, and through just spreading the word of how you become a member of the class with Bright, the class with Elevate, the class with New Execs to Kentucky, and the leadership class. It takes all of us to keep this going, what Mr. White helped establish with the board. Janice told me yesterday, she said, Perry, I had to call her first of all to make sure that I got to speak. Okay. She hit reject twice on it, but finally she answered my call. She said, yes, you get 2 minutes. You get 2 minutes. And I said, boy, that's great. You know, appreciate that. And I said, well, that's not bad. She said, Perry, there's a lot of people speaking. And said, all of them deserve to speak. And I said, no, I appreciate that too. So then last night, Ron and I got our notes, and mine had been reduced to 1 minute, and I said, I'm sure glad this is tomorrow and not the next day. And you all can see why Janice cut me down. But no, Janice has been such a pleasure to work with over time, as again has the board. One thing the 2014 class can really finally take credit for. Forever we got blamed for being the class that made it where nobody got to go to Jabez anymore. I think for anybody that went to Jabez and anybody that gets to go to the Boone Hotel in Berea now, they realize we've done Leadership Kentucky classes forward a real great job eliminating Jabez and the bunk beds. So Janice, I am done. Thank you all. Thanks for the board and their support of me. Thanks for each of the classes and the participation that you put forth. At this point, what I want to do is turn the gavel over and welcome Bowling Green's own and WKU's own Ron Wilson to the podium, as Ron will be the 2024 chair.
Perry, don't go anywhere yet. We've got something for you, and I certainly hope you had your Wheaties this morning, because our gift of appreciation weighs about 40 pounds. So let me help you with this. Good afternoon. I certainly consider this an honor to serve as chair of the board of this organization, and I certainly appreciate the opportunity to do so during our 40th year anniversary. So I think that's a special privilege for me, so I appreciate the opportunity to serve. I have a couple of thank yous. I have a commitment I want to ask of everyone in the room today, and then we're going to do a toast. So get ready for that, because that is going to be fun. We're going to have a blast. We're going to kick off our party at the end of our celebration today. My first thank you is to the gentleman who you just saw as the outgoing chair. Perry, thank you so much for leaving such a great example for me of how to be an effective chair, how to lead this organization, and thank you for all your years of service to the board and to this organization. So I appreciate you. And if I ever get in a situation where I don't know what to do as chair this year, I'm just going to stop and say to myself, what would Perry Allen do? And then I think it'll all be okay. So I think that'll guide me through, Perry, so I appreciate it. The other thank you is to Janice Way. Janice, you are the epitome of a servant leader. If everybody knows you, they know you always put everyone and everything ahead of yourself. And I certainly have appreciated getting to know you, work with you, watch you day in and day out, do everything you do for this organization. And I'm very excited to get to work closely with you as chair. So I want you to stand, because everybody in this room owes you a great debt of gratitude for your leadership. I would be remiss if I didn't give a shout out to the back of the room to my class, 2011. Best class ever, as always, right? I appreciate the friendships that we have made in that class, and I look forward to all the things that we'll do together as we move forward to help improve our state. As I said earlier, I'm going to ask a commitment of everybody in the room today, and that is to find at least one person to get involved in one of our programs of Leadership Kentucky. I hope you'll find someone and you'll tell them that you believe in them. I hope that you'll find someone and tell them that maybe you see something in them that they don't see in themselves. And so if we all recruit at least one person from Louisville to Lewisburg and from Paducah to Pikeville, then someday we'll have this whole room filled with new leaders who will someday be celebrating their annual celebration and thinking back fondly about their experience in Leadership Kentucky, just like we're doing today. So I appreciate you taking that commitment seriously. I look forward to seeing all those new faces over the coming year and years as we all go out and start to recruit someone new. Before we have our ending of our celebration, I do want to once again thank all of our sponsors that we couldn't do without. So let me mention those again. Thank you to LGNEKU, CHI St. Joseph Health, Norton Healthcare, Planters Bank, Republic Bank, Run Switch PR, U.S. Bank, Whitaker Foundation, Wyatt, and the Flame of Excellence sponsor, Sutherland and Associates, and of course, again, to the Central Bank Center for the support and assistance with this beautiful venue. So now to the fun part. Get your glasses ready. I've got mine. Run Switch PR is going to do this for us and put this on social media by photo and by video. So we are truly going to show the world what they missed today. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to count to three. And on three, we're going to all say together in our biggest, loudest, best leadership voices, happy 40th anniversary, Leadership Kentucky. And after that, I want you to break out into thunderous applause. I want you to continue toasting one another at the table, high five one another, fist bump, whatever you feel like you need to do. And please keep up the celebration for a good 15 or 20 seconds, because we want to capture by video as many of you as we can and as much of the room to put in the video. And if you happen to capture something on your phone, please share it on your social media platforms this afternoon, too. So ready? On three, it's happy 40th anniversary, Leadership Kentucky, and then the party begins. Are we ready? All right, ready. One, two, three. Happy 40th anniversary, Leadership Kentucky.